Philippine Senator Francis Tolentino set to head the Blue Ribbon Committee, which investigates alleged wrongdoing by government agencies. As Sherian Torres tells us, other members of the supermajority were assigned Senate committee chairmanships in the 19th Congress.
In his luncheon meeting with the Mama Bears Bloc led by Senator Cynthia Villar, followed by his night date with the so-called Sitmates Bloc, incoming Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri was able to seal the committee chairmanships he earlier offered to his colleagues in the 19th Congress.
We all came up very happy, and it was good bonding, good fellowship. I think it's going to be in the near future, a very good and progressive and productive Senate.
In the said meeting, each member of the supermajority bloc has agreed to accept Zubiri's offers while also recognizing his leadership. In the list provided by Zubiri's office, panels earlier tapped for Senator Sunny Angara, Nancy Binay, JV Ejercito, Jingoy Estrada, Sherwin Gachalian, Christopher Bongo, Lito Lapid, Robin Padilla, Grace Poe, Ramon Bong Revilla Jr., Rafi Tulfo, and mother and son Senators Cynthia and Mark Villa remained. Based on Zubiri's list, Senator Pia Cayetano will still chair the Committee on Sustainable Development Goals, Innovation and Futures Thinking, despite her absence in those meetings. Opposition Senator Risa Ontiveros will also keep the Committee on Women, Children, Family Relations and Gender Equality. Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa, who will continue to head the Public Order and Dangerous Drugs Panel, will also chair the Special Committee on Marawi Rehabilitation, replacing the Peace, Unification and Reconciliation Panel, which he handled in the previous Senate. Zubiri says Senator Francis Escudero will lead the Higher Technical and Vocational Education Committee and sit at the Commission on Appointments. Notable in Zubiri's list are the four committees allotted for Senator Amy Marcos, who in the previous Congress only handled two panels just like the rest of her colleagues. In the coming Senate, the sister of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. will chair the committees on foreign relations, cooperatives, social justice, and electoral reforms. Senator Francis Tolentino will chair the Blue Ribbon, Science and Technology, and Justice Committees. Senator Sherwin Gachalian says Senator Christopher Bongo will occupy his original seat in the Commission on Appointments.
Because Senator Bongo, nag-usap kami and gusto niyang umupo the whole 3 years. At sabi ko, ako naman, I'm open to that. No? Mm-hmm. Especially ngayon na I will be focusing on ways and means ng trabaho kasi yung committee na yan.
The list does not indicate any committee for Senator Alan Peter Cayetano, who has yet to commit to either the supermajority or the minority bloc. But Zubiri assures sibling Senators Pia and Alan Peter Cayetano there are still available committees for them, next to the Commission on Appointments and the Senate Electoral Tribunal.
I encourage all the senators to have a committee, whether they will work or they will not work, because also yung staffing nakasalalay sa committee. So kung wala silang committee, kulang ang staffing nila, ang MOOE nandyan. He could also be independent. There's also situations.
In a statement, Senator Alan Peter Cayetano has described Tolentino as an excellent choice for the Blue Ribbon Panel, which he had incidentally set as a condition for him to join the majority bloc. And while weighing his options as to what group to side with, Cayetano says his main consideration will always be public service and not political partisanship. Based on Zubiri's list, only three committees in the Senate are left without takers. These are the Committees on Government Corporations and Public Enterprises, Cultural Communities, as well as Ethics and Privileges. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
Beijing's top diplomat expressed hope of developing better ties with Manila as he met with Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in Malacanang on Wednesday. That's despite an ongoing maritime row between the two countries. In a Facebook post, Marcos said among the topics he discussed with Foreign Minister Wang Yi were agriculture, infrastructure, and a commitment to maintaining relations between Filipinos and Chinese.
With President Marcos being elected, China-Philippine relationship has turned a new page. We highly appreciate President Marcos' recent commitment to pursuing friendly policy toward China, and we speak highly of his recent statement that have sent out a very positive signal to the outside world.
A Chinese official also met with Vice President Sara Duterte and Philippine Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo. And while everything seemed to be cordial during Wang's visit, it comes at a time of heightened tension between the two nations. Just recently, a Philippine resupply mission to the BRP Sierra Madre at the Ayungan Shoal was given a veiled threat by the Chinese Coast Guard. Wang did not bring up the issue during his visit, only China's supposed readiness to deepen cooperation in all aspects.
It is even more important for China and the Philippines, as two close neighbors, to join hands and further enhance mutual trust, expand mutually beneficial cooperation. This will not only serve the common interest of the two countries and two peoples, but will also be our important contribution to peace and stability of our region.